हेलो एवरीवन, नॉलेज इज नॉट रेस्ट्रिक्टेड टू क्लासरूम. डू यू अग्री विद दिस पंचलाइन? दीप्ति छेड़ा हियर. आई एम अ चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट क्वालिफाइड इन द ईयर 2000 एंड लास्ट 20 इयर्स आई हैव बीन इन टीचिंग फील्ड. सो वॉच दिस वीडियो टिल एंड. लेट अस डिस्कस व्हाई देयर इज अ गैप बिटवीन थ्योरी नॉलेज एंड प्रैक्टिकल नॉलेज. Agreed, you all are going in your internship and learning a lot practical aspects. When you are in classroom, you are learning all the concepts theoretically and to the best for the exam, for the knowledge. Then why there is not a connecting bridge? I came up to discuss with this topic. The reason is, I happened to be attending an interview panel. I was sitting in the interview panel, and when we asked students this basic question, that how many balance sheet are there in the annual report? And the answer was, think what it is. How many balance sheets are there in the annual reports? Because annual reports is there in law and CA knows everything about the annual reports. Then the answer is, there are two balance sheets. One is the standalone balance sheet of the company and another is the consolidated balance sheet. So let us see, knowledge is not restricted to classroom, how we can enhance and link up our theory knowledge with our practical knowledge. So the first thing with this experience I decided I'll discuss with you all. The first thing is, the first point to correlate these two, theory and practical knowledge, is start reading annual reports. It's a superb knowledge to the best, whatever you can understand. Read it like a newspaper, it's absolutely okay, but do read it. When you read annual reports, you get to know all the formats of final accounts, how notes on accounts are written, how accounting standards and effects are given. The first thing, accounts is clear. Second is, you learn the language of auditing used by auditor. We hereby, to the best of our knowledge, that helps you in auditing. And the third aspect is ordinary resolution, special resolution, voting, quorum. So many things are there which will help you to enhance your theoretical knowledge of law. So keep reading the annual reports. With annual reports, most of you are very perfect and it's a favorite topic for all of you. What is that? Ratios and cash flow statement. Ma'am, we do it in accounts, we do it in FM, and we know everything. Good. But after calculating the ratios, can you pick up the ratios and analyze the impact of it on the company? After reading the making the cash flow statement, can we analyze actually where from the fund has come and where it is going? So analysis of these theory chapters is very important, right? The third thing I have observed is hire purchase and installment and so many other chapters wherein you all know how to work out EMI, capital budgeting. But then, have you studied the loan agreements? If not, please do it. Study the practical loan agreements. See how it is, where mortgage is used, where hypothecation is used, where pledge is used. And study these. These are the questions which are asked in interview and students are not able to face it practically. So you have to sit and study it separately, then link up that in liquidation where we are using mortgage, where we are using pledge and all these documents. So very important thing is, you read. Even in the simple question asked in interview is, when I am paying my installments, my principal is decreasing, my interest is increasing, still my EMI is same. How is it worked out? Observe the chart. Next aspect is, any of your family members, your brothers, sisters are receiving salary. You have studied salary chapter. You know how to compute salary. Can you see the pay slip, how it looks, gross salary, what are the deductions, what is PT, how the allowances and perquisites are presented? You can correlate costing labor chapter and salary chapter when you see the pay slip or their salary structure practically. Same applies for partnership. You all know partnership act in law. Partnership accounts is super favorite. Ma'am, every problem tallies in partnership. Good, but read the partnership deed. See practically how partners' accounts are prepared. In single entry, most ignored part is capital comparison method, which is actually used by partners. Right? So these are some examples I am giving. Next time a scheme comes of Big Bazaar that they are taking all your scrap and they are giving you some vouchers, understand how the schemes are made. The professionals, chartered accountants, CMA, CS, we need to work in a very fast way. In exam, you are given ready problem for amalgamation and demerger. Have you thought sometime how the scheme is made of amalgamation and demerger? So like this, there are many aspects. This is just a small list I come across every day, and I have seen students lacking in interviews and practically. I'm literally saying one small story. Hriday and Ridhan, two best friends. Hriday is academically very much ahead than Ridhan, but in case of internship in their office, Ridhan is given all the work. Do you know the reason why? Ridhan is given all the work and Hriday is not given any work. Then the reason is Ridhan knows things practically. Imagine you have to send someone to bank. Whom you will send your staff? Who knows the work well? Who will teach? So this is what I feel. This is my personal belief. It can be different. But your best mentors are your parents and your teachers. These are the people who are ready to teach you. Sometimes your peer group, your best friends. Then apart from this, others will decide. If you know, they'll give you work. If you don't know the work, they'll give it to someone else. No one is having time to teach you. So now when you are a student, don't restrict the knowledge to classroom. Link it practically, form a bridge, and headstrong you go for your interviews. I hope I have given some insights to all of you related to this topic, and take help. If you are not able to correlate these practical and theory things, ask your teachers, ask your mentors, ask your parents how they are doing all this, right? So that's why I say knowledge is not restricted to classroom. If you want to be extraordinary, if you want to bring extraordinary result, if you want to earn extraordinary, put extraordinary efforts to learn the things in all the ways, right? If you like this video, and if I have opened up the window that, okay, outside the classroom also we link the knowledge which teachers are giving in the classroom. They are giving examples. You have to link up. Next time, if you go out of this classroom and sit on your vehicle, open your vehicle dicky and check the insurance cover note. Is it annual? What is the premium? How is the agreement? It is till 12 o'clock midnight. Same, one more example I missed out. So again, I want to say banking knowledge. Learn the practical banking knowledge. I know you have a Bansi Kaka in your office who does RTGS, NIFT and demand draft and all work for you. But when you have to get work done from others, you should know how to do it. You should know what is IFSC code and all. Sometimes a simple thing, can you please tell me check number in this check? Students are not able to answer. So do you want holding a degree and lacking in these practical aspects? No. So may you make the best bridge, and may you take the knowledge all around beyond the classroom.